Roger Romo, the brother of Fernando Vargas. We're here, you're drinking protein at the World Crown Sports Center in Oxnard, the home of Sergio Martinez. Are you going to help him prepare for Darren Barker?
I should start with a hump, probably next week. Yeah.
You look British.
I'm British, come on.
Can you play the part, a Barker?
I've never seen him before.
Can he play the part of Darren Barker?
He can do anything you want.
Who's that? I've never seen him before.
Put a video
real quick
and you'll have him down in 5 seconds.
Is he one of those British guys? I'm not Murphy fight Sergio Martinez, like that, one of those guys?
He's a champ out there. I mean, he was out of the game for a minute, but he's back.
That's good. Well, he's gonna be out again after this next fight.
You heard?
Adam will never say anything.
Let me ask you this. Kelly Pavlik was supposed to have a fight, and 5 days before the fight, he kind of said, nah, I'm not going to fight. What do you think about that?
That was after the last performance, right? He
was supposed to fight this Saturday.
He was supposed to fight again. No, he probably doesn't feel it. He doesn't feel sharp as he did before anymore.
If you shaved your head, could you look like Kelly Pavlik?
I don't think I could look like him. Like an alien, you know?
What planet?
I don't know.
How about this? Mars Akbeko this weekend. Are you gonna watch it?
No.
Why not?
I don't really care for either of those guys. I'd rather watch Sergio. I haven't really been watching a lot of fights. Probably the next one I'll watch is the Mayweather one.
What do you think about Mayweather Ortiz? You know both of them very well. Have you had a chance to hang out with Mayweather at all?
I don't know how them like before, like Fernando Font Corte, him and Judah were all hanging out. But who
was hanging out with Judah?
All of us. It was after the fight. It was me, Zab, and Floyd.
What was it like rolling with Zab and Floyd and Fernando Vargas?
It was cool, man. They were all Olympic teammates. Zab was Olympic alternate, but they were all cool.
Did you learn anything from them, hanging out with them? Any good pickup lines or something?
No swag, that's about it.
Like what? Can I learn anything from them?
You probably could.
Like what?
You pick up on stuff pretty quick. I've seen that.
You know the best pickup line in Israel, where I'm from? Is your father a gardener?
Why is that? A freaking apple or something?
I just want to know you became such a flower.
You just want to know what?
How she became such a flower.
Come on.
Hey, no?
You throw an apple at a girl and all of a sudden you're telling her you like her, right?
What I throwing her?
Is that Spain or is it in Israel?
What are you throwing her?
You throw an apple at somebody.
No, where I'm from, we throw rocks.
You guys throw rocks. You guys throw Scud missiles and shit.
We don't mess around.
Addison said he's a Mexican Jew. That's what Fernando said.
Yeah, Fernando said. I'm the first Mexican Jew he's met in a while.
Well, that's true, man, right?
There are a lot of Jews in Mexico. Mexico City.
Yeah, man.
I don't think we have any Mexican Jewish fighters.
Really? No.
There's one heavyweight Israeli, or I'm sorry, he's a cruiserweight. He's a Nakash. He might fight in the Playboy Mansion soon.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. Against another dude. He's not fighting the Playboy Mansion.
Is he Jewish?
Yeah. He trains in Philly. He's pretty good. I think he's 20-0 or 18-0.
I think he's awesome, man. You know? Shoot.
What about Yuri Foreman?
Yuri Foreman, I'm waiting for him to come back. His last fight?
Didn't he hurt his knee?
No, that was against Cotto.
Yeah, is he good now?
He came back one fight and it didn't work out too well. It was against...
It was the
Polish guy, Paweł Wallach, who fought his last fight on ESPN and looked amazing. Where in his head, he looked like the Elephant Man.
Yeah.
But I talked to him a week later and he was cool.
I think it's a pretty slick fight. Gets back on the ball. And he's pretty slick, like when he fought
Who is this?
Daniel Santos.
Yeah, Santos was here in the gym.
Who is this? Yuri Foreman.
He was 28-0. Listen, he came from an area in Russia where they had a nuclear bomb. Then he grew up in Israel. And then he came here, and it's tough, you know, but he still made it. Say what you're going to say.
You escaped aid from a fucking nuclear bomb? That's huge.
You know what he told me? That when you fly with an airplane and you leave the area at night, the cucumbers on the ground, they all shine like aluminum foil. They glow.
Radiation.
How thick is that?
It's crazy.
That's why the Klitschko's are so big.
I think they should eat them.
What I mean if you ate something like that?
I don't know.
You'll be like Superman? They'll test you positive for radiation?
Radioactive man.
What do you want to talk
I don't know. What would happen? What do you think?
In The Simpsons, they always talk about radioactive
exactly, that's
man.
That's why, radioactive man from The Simpsons. I thought you wouldn't have caught on to that. You caught on to it.
I'm a quick guy.
You're a bright guy, honey.
What's up? How are you doing?
Good. How you doing?
We're in Port Hueneme, and you look like a pirate.
You're a pirate, huh? With the bandana?
He's the one who actually started it. And then Fernando picked it up off of him. That's
Fernando got it off you?
Yeah. I put him on the bandana again. And he kind of perfected it.
Yeah, he did. He walked into the ring with it. You know what would be the sickest ring entrance? And I worked on it when I was in Israel not too long ago? On a camel. No one's ever done that.
Well, Prince Nassim came close on a flying carpet.
I know, but he never came in a flying camel.
Thank you.
How would you come into the ring? You have a fight August 27th?
I was thinking of a little Michael Myers thing, going there with a Halloween mask with the Michael Myers music playing with the lights off. You hear that Michael Myers music, what do you think?
I'm not familiar with them.
You're not familiar with Michael Myers?
I heard of Austin Powers.
Come on, man.
Who's Michael Myers?
Yeah, the freaking guy that...
Halloween.
He goes around...
He goes around murking everybody. He got out of the...
What, Scream?
He got out of the crazy home. Watch this guy right here.
Put the music on, right away.
You're gonna come out with the mask, like Scream? That would be dope.
It's not a Scream mask, it's a Michael Myers mask. It's a white mask.
With the face.
The guy's tall too, he's about 6'3", so.
You should do that. But I think actually.
An October fight, right?
To be honest with you, Prince Nassim did that too.
No, he didn't.
He came out with a bunch of
tombstones. Yeah. Not like that. If you hear that music and you're like a horror movie fan, you know right away something's going down. Someone's gonna get murdered.
But August 27th, that's not Halloween night. That's not even close.
No matter, you hear that music, someone's gonna die, right?
You know, Floyd once came out. I think he was on stilts and he was shooting money in the crowd, and it was fake money. It was Monopoly money. I thought it was real dollars.
Were you jumping for it? Yeah. You were jumping for it. Come on.
People were running up to me and giving it to me, and I thought, oh, cool. He wasn't making it rain. He was littering.
He did on the WWE, right?
Yeah, when he punched the guy and he broke the guy's nose. You saw that?
Yeah. He got paid for that.
Which boxer today would you put in the WWE? Who's the best actor in boxing?
Best actor?
There's no actor in boxing.
Yeah, there is.
No, man, she got Kevin Garza.
I can say something, but it'd be pretty offensive, but because I know who's acting right now. But
comedians or
no,
actors?
No, I mean acting. I know someone who's putting on a major act right now just to sell a fight. And if you're watching it and you're in Ventura County and you're watching this, you know who I'm talking about. So, off camera, I'll tell you who that is. Ellie.
You know who it is. You're shaking your head.
Off camera, I'll tell you. Right.
Okay, off camera. I'm not sure.
What you talking about?
I don't know.
I got my SAG card.
You do?
Yeah.
Are you an actor? You've been in any commercials, any movies?
You ever seen Snake Eyes?
Snake Eyes.
No, but I met Sergio Mora, the Latin Snake. Does that count?
That's an actor right there, eh?
Who's Snake Eyes? Is that with Dice, right?
No, I was with the...
No, you...
Yeah, you Snake Eyes, yeah.
Hey, what movie is it?
You've seen a Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, what did you play in that movie?
Were you a fighter in that.
You were the fighter in it?
Yeah, I was the heavyweight champion of the world.
Raj, is he kidding or is he serious?
That what?
That he was in a movie playing the heavyweight fighter of the world.
Yeah,
in Snake...
man, it was on Snake Eyes. Nicolas Cage,
Gary Sinise was in it.
That's cool. Dude. How did you like
Gary
that?
Gary's cool, man.
You should bring him to the gym sometime. Spar with them.
I don't know where the hell he's at.
What happened to Tulsa?
What happened to your championship belt?
Oh, yeah, I still have that.
Snake Eyes, I'm going to go rent it today.
Yeah, Rent is a good movie, bro.
Who would play Roger? If they made a movie about Roger Romo, which Hollywood actor would you cast?
Oh, let me see. Timberlake, you know.
Justin Timberlake.
Oh man,
can you imitate him?
I could do what he does in the streets, but other than that,
how's that song go?
What does he do? Jaywalk?
No, he doesn't do that.
How's that song go?
He's a
bye bye
he's
bye.
An outgoing guy. Yeah. He's very outgoing.